Hello students, let's learn some new things in chapter number 15, visualizing solid shapes. So exercise 15.3, it's introduction. Now in this introduction, the topic is viewing different sections of a solid. To view the different sections of a solid, number one way is to view an object is by cutting or slicing, which is called a slicing game, or we can say that kitchen play. Now here in size slicing, for an example, when you purchased a bread, you can see the bread is already sliced. Now when we compare this slicing cut, so it is nothing but when a bread loaf cut vertically, we get this kind of bread what we are purchasing. Now so it is called vertical cut. For an example, here you can see that. Also we can cut a bread loaf horizontally like this. Here you can see that this is a horizontal cut. So in this slicing game, two cut we can do. One is vertical this way and another one is horizontal. So let's see exercise 15.3, which is based on vertical cut and horizontal cut. So in exercise 15.3, there is only one question, question number one. What is it? It says that what cross sections do you get when you give number one a vertical cut and number two horizontal cut to the following solids: A brick, B round apple, C die, D a circular pipe, and E an ice cream cone. So here what we have to do, this different solids are given and we have to cut these solids vertically and horizontally. Now when we cut these solids, the inside part, we can see that that part is nothing but a cross section. For an example, here when you are getting a bread loaf, that is bread, so inside bread you get a cut, different cuts of a bread, a sliced bread. So in that sliced bread, the white part what you see in a bread, it is nothing but a cross section. For an example, here inside this part what you are seeing, that is called cross section. So that cross section, which kind of shape that cross section looks like, that we have to tell. Let's start to solving this question number one. Number one, a brick. Now we have to cut this brick vertically and horizontally, and inside what the cross section we are seeing, that we have to tell. So first of all, we give this brick a vertical cut, means this way. So when we cut this brick, it divide in two parts, and inside this part is called a cross section, and it looks like nothing but a rectangle. Now we have to do the horizontal cut of the brick, means when we cut horizontally, it divides in these two parts, and inside this part it is nothing but a cross section, and it looks like also a rectangle. But when we compare these two rectangles, that is a vertical cut and a horizontal cut cross section, the vertical cut cross section is smaller than a horizontal cut cross section. They are same rectangle, but one is smaller and another one is bigger. Next, a round apple. A round apple looks like a sphere. Now when we give a vertical cut to a round apple, from this one it divides in two parts, and inside whatever we can see, that is cross section, and it is nothing but a circle, looks like a circle. Now we have to do a horizontal cut. When we cut horizontally this round apple, it divides in two parts, and inside whatever we can see, there is nothing but a cross section, and it looks like this, a circle. Next, a die. Die is nothing but a solid shape which is nothing but an example of a cube. So here when we give a vertical cut to a die, it divides in two parts, and inside the cross section which we can see, it is nothing but an example of a square. Now in a die, when we do horizontal cut from this part, And when we see the cross section, it is nothing but also a square. And these two squares are equal. Next, a circular pipe. D, a circular pipe. It is nothing but an example of a cylinder. Now, when we cut this circular pipe from vertical cut, it divides in two parts, and inside the cross section, what we can see, it is nothing but a circle. And when we give a horizontal cut to the circular pipe, means from this way, and when we see from up the cross section, it looks like this way. That is nothing but a rectangle. So in a circular pipe, when we give vertical cut, the cross section looks like circle, and when we give horizontal cut, the cross section looks like a rectangle. Next, E, an ice cream cone. We can give a vertical cut when to a ice cream cone from this way, and when we see the cross section, it looks like the slice of a pizza, and it almost looks like triangle. So when we give an ice cream cone a vertical cut, the shape we get, it is a triangle. Now, when we give a horizontal cut to this ice cream cone, we get two different kind of a cross section. For an example, when we see this cross section, it looks like a circle, and inside another circle. So this first cross section we get, it is nothing but a concentric circle. That means two circles are there having same center, two circles, concentric circle. And another cross section means from this one, what we get, it looks like this, a circle inside one point, that is center point, we can see. So in an ice cream cone, when we give vertical cut, it looks like triangle, and when we give horizontal cut, it looks like a circle. One section looks like concentric circles, and one is a one single circle. So this question is over. After solving all the sums, we have to make this kind of table, and this table are divided into three columns, one for solid, another one for shape of cross section of vertical cut, and third one for shape of cross section for horizontal cut. Now we'll start with a brick. Brick is nothing but one example of a solid cuboid. Now, when we give vertical cut to a brick, shapes of cross section we get, it is nothing but a rectangle. And when we give horizontal cut to a brick, we get a shape of cross section, which is also a rectangle. For a round apple is nothing but an example of a solid sphere. When we give a vertical cut to this round apple, shape of cross section we get, it is nothing but a circle. And when we give a round apple a horizontal cut, a shape of cross section we get, it is also a circle. Next, a die. Die is an example of nothing but a solid cube. Here, a die, when we give vertical cut to a die, the cross shape of cross section we get, it is a square. And also, when to a die we give horizontal cut, a shape of cross section we get, it is also a square. Next, a circular pipe. A circular pipe is an example of a solid cylinder. Now, here, to this circular pipe, when we give vertical cut, we get a shape of cross section, which is nothing but a circle. And to a circular pipe, when we give horizontal cut, the shape of cross section we get is also a rectangle. So here in circular pipe, when we give vertical cut, it is circle. And when we give horizontal cut, we get rectangle cross section. Last, an ice cream cone. This ice cream cone is an example of a solid circular cone. Here, to this cone, when we give a vertical cut, the shape of cross section we get, it is a triangle. And when we give horizontal cut, a shape of cross section we get a circle.